So guys, in continuation, we have this particular problem here. And I said the shape is based on the side of the shape here is based on the line that you actually the lines that you actually have here. If you have three lines, you are expected to have three sides for any shape that you have inside this puzzle. I have three lines here and I have a shape here. Automatically speaking, the lines must correlate with the number of sides that you have for the shape. That's the concept. I have one line here and I have a circle here. If you have one line here, then this shape must have one side alone. So now look at this. I have three lines. Okay, so you are expected to have six sides for the shape. Yeah, I have four lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you are expected to have a four-sided shape. So now if you look at option A, I have three lines here, but this shape is not three-sided, and this is wrong. For option B, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have five lines, and this shape is not five-sided, and that is wrong. This is just three sides. So now here in this case, we have four lines. And I have a square which has four sides. So this satisfies. What of this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one will also satisfy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one is wrong. So we are left with option C and D. I need one person to explain that, please. Hey. I only need one person. It's just one person. Let me try to get it clearly, please. Let's allow one person to talk, please. Just hold on. Who is going first? All right, good. I'm with you. I can hear you. Why? Triangle. The first shape, which is triangle. Okay, so it's actually based on where we have the lines. It's at the top, it should be at the bottom. Now it's meant to be at the top, then at the bottom, then at the top. So for this one, we'll go for option C. So is that clear, guys? No problem. Yeah, it's correct. Let's just go with this. Do we all accept that the answer is D? I understand. Yeah. So let's go to the next question. D is correct, right? Do we all agree that D is correct? So let's just move straight to the next question. So I know there are other methods too. There are other methods. Let's just go with this. All right. So wait, why is this thing still on page 152? What's going on? Okay, now we have this. Seriously, I thought it's just four more pages and we are ready. Okay, now for this one, what's going on here? Okay, let me start with at. I have at here at the bottom right. Okay, I think this at is moving towards anti-clockwise direction. Now I'll go to the left, then I have it here, then at the top. Then it goes to the right. Then this art is meant to come back here. Do you guys understand that part? Like, good. Thank you. So that means is that we go for option A, option B. This one is out. This one is what is the very four choices? Oh my god. Another pattern. Opposite. Thank you. That's diagonally, left, right, diagonal. Diagonally, they must be opposite at B. This is opposite left to right, and this is also diagonal. Okay, wait. I'm coming. Let me try to get it clearly. But I want to check the direction. Okay, it should be okay. That means this one is out. This one is correct. This one is out. A and E. A and E. We are left with A and E now. A and E, guys. A and E. B and E. Thank you. B and E. So we are left with B and E. So guys, I want someone to help me out with the last part. Thank you. All right. Thank you. This hash sign is at the right, then at the left, then to the right, then to the left, then to the right. So that means option E qualifies, and that's the final result. Let's move straight to the next question. So is that clear, guys? So let's move. Now we have this now. Okay, let me start with, how many triangles do we have here? Two, then I have one. Is that a good pattern? Absolutely no. No. Okay, let me start with the line that separates the shape. This line separated this shape, right? And it's horizontal. And then I have this diagonally, then it's straight. So that means this line is moving counterclockwise. Counterclockwise, like this, okay? So if I move this one counterclockwise, I have this towards 45 degrees, all right? Then again, I have this, then to go back to its original position like this. Okay, that means this is what we are looking for. The next box should be like this, but we don't need this. But for this one, that means it should have looked like this. So if I rotate this one counterclockwise towards 45 degrees, it's going to look like this horizontally. So that means option A, or we have option C and D. This one is out, this one is out. So I think that is clear to, is that clear to everyone? That first part, is it clear to everyone? Is it clear to everyone? Okay, let me try to, no, not somebody, let me try to explain that again. Okay, so to be cloudy. Now, let me explain this again. Look at this line, okay, that divides any of this shape into two equal parts. This line here is horizontal, okay? And if I try to rotate this line in counterclockwise direction, like counterclockwise, okay, it's going to look like this. And take note, the rotation is actually based on 45 degrees. If this is angle 90, 45 degrees means something like this. And that's why we have this line in the second shape, in the third shape, rather. So I repeat, I have a horizontal line here. If you rotate this in a counterclockwise direction towards 45 degrees, you have this slant line. And if you rotate it again towards 45 degrees in counterclockwise direction, you're going to have a straight line. If you do that again counterclockwise towards 45 degrees, you're going to have this slant line here. Okay? So that means if you want to get the first one, okay, if I have this horizontal line, I'll just take it this way. It's going to look like this. So that if I rotate this one counterclockwise towards 45 degrees, it's going to look like this. So is it clear now? Is it clear to everyone? Or is it still not clear? It's clear. The line part is clear now. So now the second thing is, I notice that I have just in the first portion of the division, you know, this line divides this shape into two parts. The first portion we always have just one shape. Look at this again, one shape. First part here, one shape. First part here, one shape. Now for the second part, one shape, two shapes, three shapes. Hey, it does not work. Oh yeah, all right, okay, I need somebody to explain this. Go ahead, please. Yeah. Wait, hold on. Yeah, too fast. Hold on, please. Let's take it slowly. Don't worry, Shu. You are still going too fast. The edges. Hold on. I'm coming. Wait. For this one. Hold on, wait. Slowly. Thank you very much. Now let's start with this one first. Let's start with this. I say. All right, this second. Let's start with this. All right. Yeah, go ahead. I'm with you. Oh, our network is very bad. Can you guys hear me? Can anyone hear me?
Yeah.
But I can't hear. Or is it my network? This triangle has three sides. I can't really hear. I don't know. Is it my network, guys? Can you guys hear? Okay, that means we are doing calculation here. Whatever you have here, if you have three sides, it must be equal to this one. Sister, I want to ask you one question. How did you manage to think to that extent? Oh my god. Seriously? Yeah, okay. Okay. I'm coming. This one has one side. Four sides. That makes it how many sides? One, two, four, five, six. Six sides, correct? One side, three sides. How did you manage to think to that extent? God. And for the rest of this, I was trying to, give my own explanation with confidence. We have one shape here, one shape, and this one, 1, 2, 3. Oh my god. And the last one just. And if I did that way. So this one should be, are you sure that I'm correct? My own method is not correct. My own method is not correct, but I think our own. Are you sure that our own is not correct? Guys, wait. Hold on, please. Just hold on. I'm coming, guys. Just hold on. We actually said that what we are going to have here is a slant line like this, and that is option A, option C. Or option D. Based on what the lady said, let's see how many sides. How many sides do we have here? Four sides. One side. And that makes it how many? Four, five, six. And this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is out of it. Now let's go to option C. One side, four sides. This is five sides. And it forms a pentagon. This is correct. And then I have I have five sides here. I have one side there, and this is wrong. So the answer is C. Do you all agree with that now? That lady is a scholar. Give it to her. That lady is a scholar. Give it to her. I think that's clear. All right, let me explain for the last time. Guys, We have 15 minutes to go, right? Or is it 10 minutes? How many minutes left? 15 minutes. Now let me explain this for the last time. So guys, in this case, we all agree that we are going to have this particular line in this format. And that is why we went for option A or option C or option D. Now, the other lady said, in order for us to get the right shape, all right, pick this. If you pick this particular shape here, this is a triangle, and it has how many sides? Three sides. The number of sites here must be equal to the number of sites you have in the other space. All right. Now let's take this space here and take this shape. This shape has how many sites? 3 sites. This one has how many sites? 5 sites. So if I sum this one together, it's 8 in total. And if you look at the other space, I have an octagon here, which has 8 sides. This is an octagon, not a circle. Please take note. This has 8 sides. Side 1, side 2, side 3, that's 8 sides. Now, let's go straight to the next one, which is this. And looking at this one, I have 4 sides here. This is square, it has 4 sides. This is circle, it has 1 side. This is circle, it has 1 side. So if I sum it up, I'm going to have 4 plus 1, 5 plus 1. That's 6. Now, this is 6. So if you look at the other space, this shape also has how many sides? 6 sides. And that is correct. If you do the same thing for this one, 4 sides here. I have 3 sides and I have 1 side. That makes it 4 and 4. 4 and 4. That's correct. Now, let's see which one is going to be the right option between A. They said you should drop your number, Abby. A, C, and D. Now, for this A part, looking at this shape, that's 4 sides. Looking at this shape, I have 1 side. Looking at this one, I have 1 side. And I have, in total, if I sum it up, I'm going to have 4 plus 1, 5 plus 1, 6. So there are 6 in total. And here, in this case, I have how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 5. Are they equal? No. And this one is out of it. Now, let's go straight to option D. I have 4 sides here. I have 1 side here. I have 5 side there. If I sum this one up, I have 6. 6 and 4. Are they equal? No. Take it off. What of this one? 1 side, 4 sides, 5. And here I have 5 sides. Are they equal? Yes. So option C is correct. So guys, I hope that is clear now. Is it clear to everyone? Okay. So now let's... Please, you guys can mute. I think that noise is disturbing. Please. Somebody, that person should mute. Ah, now we are in chemistry. What is this? What's the name of this thing, Seth? I've forgotten this thing. But... Conical flux. All right, so guys, let me try to explain this. Let me try if I can explain. Let me just try. I should give it to that lady to solve it. I think she's a scholar, sure. But what I need to say is that we are going to have two circles here, one big, one small. I'm going to have 3 circles here. 2 circles, 3 circles, 2 circles, 3 circles, 2 circles. The analogy. Let me come back again. Let me explain that again. I'm going to have 2 circles here, one big, one small. 3 circles, one big, medium, small. 2 circles. Then I'm going to have 3 circles here, then followed by what? 2 circles. So I need 3 circles on the conical flux, right? And I should go with... Just wait, I'm coming. Let me try to explain it first. Okay, you said A, right? Let me take note of that. If it's A, I'll come back for it. I'm coming. So now we have A, B, or... This one is out, this one is out, this one is out. So we only have... So I'm coming now. I'm coming. I have 3 circles. One big. Okay, I think this one said they're the same. They're not even one big and 2 small circles. Okay. I need somebody to explain why it is A. The lady that said A. Can you please explain? The lady that said A. Hello. Hey. We have 2 more scholars here. The lady that said A. Hello. Hello. The lady that said A. The lady that said A should please explain. The lady that said A should please explain. I'm hearing 2 voices. So. Alright, go ahead. Empty. Wait, I'm coming. I don't understand. I don't understand. Hold on. Empty, half full. Empty, half full. Guys, you people are winding me up. Is this one empty? Is this one empty? I can see. Okay. Just one shape. All right. That's correct. Let's just go with that. Yeah, sure. I understand that. I'm just joking. Wait, guys, how many of us are here, sir? I'm on this class and get us to be. Let me check. Are you for real? 76. No wonder. That's why. It's 81. Oh my god. Oh my god. Anyways, let's just continue. Okay. So we have this. Alright, so we have one empty half full. One empty half full. So we are going with option A. So option A is correct. So is that clear, guys? So can I move straight to the next one? Or is that all? Okay. So guys, this is the last question for 8 minutes. All right, no problem. This is the last one. I think this one is going to be very, very difficult. And if it's not, no problem. Please go ahead. This is your first time and... Today is the fifth. Is today the fourth day or the fifth day? Today is the fifth day since Saturday. You can, you know, you have not missed a lot. You can, all right, you know what? You can just take your time. Just take your time. You can try to. All right, let me just help them out with that. So, guys, I'll copy the link now. The link to the other classes, let me just copy it and paste it here so we can move on from there. I'm coming. Where's my mouse? All right. I'm coming. Or somebody should just drop the link for them. Drop it on the group. The link to my YouTube playlist. Yeah. So I also do that for me. Let me just copy. I can't share this. I'm coming. Let me view. Yeah, that's why I want to drop. Yeah, that's why I want to drop the link now. Right, I'll drop the link now. I was wondering why is it that this class is just full today? So I know that we are even up to 70 something. Okay, so guys, that's the link. So you can copy that link to your clipboard now. Okay, so please take notes. Let's just continue from where we actually stopped. That question, Abby. But you said it yesterday that one question, if we can't solve that question, it does not mean that we are going to fail now. But don't worry, I'll try to present it. Yeah, sure. Since we have full house today, yeah, sure, you're right. I'll try to present it again. I'll show it to everyone. I'll show it to everyone. So now this is the last. I'll show it immediately after this. I'm going to show that question. So one side. So you have 5 more minutes to go. Now looking at this one here, I need somebody to help me out, please. Oh, my head is full already. One, Abby. I need one person, please. Just one person, please. Just one person. All right, go ahead. Block. Which one? From here, you want to start with the X, right? Now, the X, is at the top right, is moving, okay, to the left. Nice, yeah. Thank you, thank you. I think that's clear. So that means for this first puzzle, we are going to have our X here. Right? Do we all agree with that? So option A, B, C. Ah, but that's not a smart move. four options are correct. Four options are correct. Anyways, she's correct. She's correct. Guys, hello. Hello, guys. Hello, guys. She's correct. She's correct, but that is not the smart way to move. What of the arrow? Hey. The triangle is faster, right? Which one is faster? Guys, hello. All I know is that option E is wrong. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 options left. So what's the next thing? What do you want me to pick next? Star. Okay, let me go with the star. Hold on. Now let me go with the star. I need somebody to please explain. So what's happening with the star? Just one person. Third colon. Thank you. Fourth colon. The first one. Thank you. Second. Okay. This question mark should be in the second colon. Second colon, right? Yeah, I think that's clear. Is that clear to everyone? Is it clear to everyone? I should explain. So that means this one is out. This one is out. This one stays. This one stays. And this one stays. Now this one is out. Now we have three options left. No, D also stays. Yeah, B, C, and D. Now we are left with B, C, and D. Now should we go for triangle? We should go for the triangle. Triangle is at the first colon here, then second colon, third colon, then fourth. No, the triangle will help now. First colon, second colon, third one, fourth one. So it should be at the last one here. The triangle should be at the last one. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I've seen that. Thank you. So the triangle will not work. What of the square or the arrow? The arrow, which one? Or the circle? The rectangle, the square rather. Now, if I go with the square, I have it here. Then it moves straight to the last part, like this. Guys, hello. Trivially speaking, is the arrow that will work? This star will not work. Okay, this square will not work. We have it in the same position, the same colon. Triangle will not work, right? So let's just go with the arrow. Let's just go with the arrow. The arrow should work. Let's check out the arrow. All right, now the arrow is here. Now, is that a... So now let me explain that. We have the arrow at the last position here. Then it goes back to the first position, the second position, then the third position. Since we have the arrow at the last position here, so it should be at the fourth position, the fourth colon. Right, so and that should be, is it this? That should be third colon. Thank you, third. So that means this one is out. Then we are left with option C and D. Right, I check for the circle. So for the circle, I have it in the second colon. I'm with you. Please go ahead. Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah, it's not easy. Now, let me please join the next one. Where is this thing, sir? And that was so fast. Wow, that was so fast. You put up to 47 years just now. All right, so guys, can you hear me? Can you hear me? All right, good. Let me just go ahead and share my screen. Okay, it's coming up already. Can you guys see my screen now? Is it up now? All right. So I have this. Yeah, what's the question, please? The rule will not be given. It will not be given. Ha, look at it. I didn't think the rule is given. It will be very, very easy. I will not even spend more than 1 minute. I will see the code. All right, I'll see the code. The difference between this PDF and that of Dragnet is that, yeah, the rule is given, but the answer is not given. Okay, the rule is always given, but the answers are not given, right? So, but if you check the Dragnet test, the PDF itself, the answers are there, both the answer and the rule. All right, so now let me scroll up. Now we are still on this question. Can you please mute? I don't know who is that. Okay, so let me clear everything, sir. We are left with option C or D. So we want to C and D. I want to go with the circle. So for the circle now, I have it here. Yeah, we have cleared up the arrow part. The arrow is at the third position. That was how we arrived at C or D. So now the only thing we have left now is the circle. And for the circle now, I can see it here. Can somebody explain the circle part? Okay, I noticed one thing about the circle. I should have a circle and a space. A circle and a space. Then the next should be star. I think it's from your end. Can other people see my screen? Can you guys see my screen? Maybe. Yeah, probably is this network. You can try to disconnect and then join again. All right. So guys, what I notice here is that. So guys, it should be D. Yeah. What I notice here is that I have a black circle here, right? And if I have a black circle, the next thing that should come to the right should be empty. And after the empty box, I should have an X box. All right. Okay. So let's see. Looking at this, I have like two. I have like two empty boxes here, so I can't go with option C. And if I want to go with option D, okay, I should have a black circle followed by empty box and an X, and which is true for this one. I have a black circle here followed by empty and then followed by X. So D is correct. So do you all understand that? Is that clear to everyone? Yeah. All right, go ahead, please. I can hear you. I did not get. Please come again. The first, all the symbols are moving. Good. One. Okay. The what? Please, let's take it slowly. Please. You said the circle and the X. What do you say? I don't get that part. The circle and the X are moving to the left. Backward, yeah. Left, yeah, sure. Good. To the right. Okay. Good. Correct. To the left. Correct. To the right. Okay. Yeah. Left. Right. Left. Right. That's also correct. So which one is faster? Now, looking at this, looking at this, can you easily detect that? Can you Can you easily detect this inside the exam? That's the question. Yeah. Easy to quickly detect. Your mind will not go straight to two boxes at a time. That's just it. That's just my own point. You get everybody. Your mind will be on just one shape alone, not the two at once. But if you can actually think to that extent, like taking two shapes at once, you easily get this straight up. Yeah, thank you very much for that. Thank you. I think that's clear now. Another scholars in the house. Yeah, I'm with you. Yeah, go ahead, please. Yeah, I'm here. Yeah, this one, yeah. The arrow to the square. Okay, good, correct. Wow, that is very, very fast. Thank you. It's very, very fast. This one is very, very fast. Yeah, it is. I think it's from your end. It's from your end. So guys, this is what they are trying to explain. For the first person, she said, this triangle is pointing directly to the square. And then for the next one, it's empty. For the next one, it's pointing directly to the square. For the next one, it's empty. So what should this one be? That means the triangle is pointing to empty. To empty, just empty, not to square. The second one is pointing directly to a square. Why it is empty, then to square, empty. So that means the first one is empty. Like, I don't have anything here. It's empty. So now let's check. This one is empty. That will not work. Empty, 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 empty. Okay, what do you mean? Okay. Yeah. Sorry for that. One person should talk, please. Let's allow her to talk, please. Let's allow her to talk, please. I'm not sure yet. That is it not work. I sure it works. Everything. Okay, wait. It's also empty for A. That's what I'm saying. It's also empty for A. But it's faster enough than what we have been doing, because I'll be able to detect that A and B. Unlike the first one that we did, we have like four options correct. So then we have two left now. Then you have to pick it up from here. And that's all. So the guys, let's just conclude there. That's basically all for abstract reasoning. So guys, I think we have been able to finish up everything under abstract reasoning. That's everything on abstract reasoning from all the PDF that I've seen. I don't know whether there's any other abstract reasoning from other PDFs. That's why it's not A, it's D. Who said A? Please take note, it's D. Yeah, sure, that's the next thing, yeah, sure. I remember, I'll do that. But I want us, don't worry, don't mind them. Now, looking at this, guys, I want us to understand this past question clearly, because we have a lot of past questions out there, and we need to shuffle out the ones that are important. I don't even know. In fact, all of them are important. Yeah, let me just put it that way. So, guys, looking at this PDF clearly, let me try to switch to this. Looking at this PDF, let me try to scroll up. Like, we have how many sections here? Let me make it clear now. Coming. So this particular PDF that we have here, it has four different sections, if I'm not mistaken, or three. So we have the abstract reasoning. For those that are just joining for the first time, So I'm glad to tell you that we have actually completed everything on abstract reasoning. I repeat, we have completed everything on abstract reasoning. And if I say that I've completed everything on abstract reasoning, that does not mean we have read everything under abstract. There are still more, like thousands of questions, thousands. So guys, this is what I want to tell you guys. For this abstract reasoning, we only have 30 questions here. If you look at it clearly, number one, number two, up to this last part, which is number 30. We only have 30 questions, just 30 of them. Can you see this number 23? The last one is 30. Just 30. I can't even scroll up, sir. So I have just 30 questions. So now, if you need more, you need to go and check the Dragnet test PDF. I think I've sent that to the group yesterday. You can check it out. And I'm not sure that do I have it here? Let me check first. So you see more. You see more of it. And it's even word for word. I even saw it inside the Dragnet. Somebody will send it. Don't worry. Somebody should drop that. Somebody should drop that for you guys. Somebody will drop that for you guys. I don't know why I can't scroll. Let me use my mouse. So I'm trying to look for the Dragnet PDF so I can show us. This is it. Dragnet aptitude test. You can all see this. Now, remember that this was the exact PDF that we're using. We're using this particular PDF here, and we have 30 questions under abstract reasoning. I can boldly tell you that those 30 questions are inside this Dragnet test, and it's actually inside chapter 6. For let me try to open this for me. So this is the Dragnet study pack. So if I scroll down to page 622, let me just type that here. Page 622. So just check page 622. So like I said, we have thousands of questions, thousands. Can you see the 30 questions that we have in that PDF that we're actually working with? These are the questions here, starting from number one, word for word, the same diagram, no difference, up to question number 30. You see it for yourself. Let's see. Let me scroll down to question number 30. If you are familiar with this thing, see the puzzle that we did together. And if you jangle it, let me just scroll down to the last question. Can you see this? This is the last question that we just did, word for word, 30 questions. So if you think you have actually studied everything on abstract reasoning, you're on your own. We still have more. That is for only, maybe they took chapter 5 for year 2019. I don't know. I don't know where they picked that question from. All I know is that the question is here. Okay, now that means we still have more. Can you see this? This is also abstract reasoning test, chapter 6. Okay. What do you say? No, they will drop it on the group. You are on the group, right? Somebody will drop it for you guys. Or probably after this class, I will drop it too. I'll drop it for you. All right, you know what? You have my number, right? You have my number, right? No problem. You have my number, right? Okay, let me drop my number. Just message me. Then I'll pick it up from there. Okay? Somebody should... Okay, let me just drop my number. So I think that will be sorted out. Just message me. I'll send you the PDF. So that will sort out the problem. So, guys, that question... We have... I'll do that. So guys, let's quickly look into that question before time runs out. 0079352974. So guys, that's my number. Okay, just message me on WhatsApp. I'll pick it up from there. So I need somebody to drop that question. Mr. Lawa, Abi. Mr. Lawa, can you drop that question on the group so I can pick it up from here? That is that question. My system is already low. I don't know. Probably I'll join my phone. I'll make sure I join my phone. Yes, that question for yesterday. I don't know. If you have it, you can just... Or if anyone has it. Yesterday. It's our system. And okay. Let me try to check if I can see it for me. Hold on, guys. Let me scroll. I can't even pick it up. I'm not sure. And the lady that actually sent it, I did not save her number. Yeah, I don't save that. I've not saved my number. I don't save my number. Let me check. I'm not sure. Are you sure that I save my number? NNPC, Abi. Okay, I should. Okay, let me check. I think I still remember our profile picture. I should be able to detect that. I'm coming. I think she's there. I think it's this lady. She's the one. This one here. I think she's the one. Let me check. Yeah, she's the one. So, guys, I want us to look at this question clearly. Look at this question. My mouse is. Don't worry, I'll drop it after the class. Don't worry, I'll drop everything after the class. You've joined the group, right? I'll try to drop it after the class. Let me save this before this system runs out because it's about to go off.